Hey YouTube, Coppersan here. We've been active in Reboot on our mains for 150 days now. Today we're looking back at how we have progressed and showcasing just how far we have come. About 150 days ago, we created Coppershade and iPallyXtree, who were going to be our mains in eReboot. Little did we know about how progression was going to play out and where we would end up at the end of the year. I already had some characters in Reboot at that time, so we already had 3k Legion and some Link skills to help out. Femke accounted like 3 characters on it, so she had a bit more work ahead of herself. We spent most of our early days in Reboot completing content, so we could start unlocking boss monsters and other content, completing the Silent Crusade questline, the Temple of Time, and the Volleying questline, just to name a few. And back then, we still needed to clear the Rude Abyss bosses 10 times before we could fight their Chaos versions, so that was also taking up some time. We both started out as burning characters, so we had temporary Fafnir gear that we were using to carry ourselves with through the early game. If you do plan on starting out your main, waiting for a burning event with those rewards is definitely worth it. It saves you a lot of time, especially in Reboot. I also got my first familiar badge and unlocked my pocket slot just to get myself ready for the content that was about to come. It wouldn't be until much later that I actually started working on my familiars. In the first week, we managed to get level 207, and we just slowly worked our way towards higher levels while also working on Legion characters. But Legion wouldn't still be the main focus for a while. The gear I was using back then was pretty cute as well. Some clean boss accessories, and I remember Horntail just refusing to drop his earrings, and I didn't have any decent shoulders or totems back then, but that was all about to change. The next thing that we did was leveling a lot so we could unlock more dailies. Leveling was important for us because of the burning event. We would get a nice event ring at level 210 and a fake Abslab weapon at level 220. I already missed that window on my hero, so I needed to reach it on my Shade. This event also gave us more node stones and EXP nodes stones that helped us a lot to get started on upgrading our 5th job skills. It was also double miracle time, and I equipped a ton of my accessories, secondary and emblem at that time. We also finally found better earrings from Horntail and some shoulders from Magnus, and I replaced some of my other gear like my cape for example with the drops I'd gotten from normal Magnus as well. After all this cubing and upgrading, we doubled our range to 9k main stats, then reached Lechelin, and I started working on my Legion a bit more around this time. I pushed it to almost 4k and I was focusing on my Phantom, Eren and Blaster for their Legion effects and Link skills. At this point, we could also duo normal Magnus and Chaos Akum, and I soloed hard Hilla, who still had her cage mechanic at this point. With 10k stats and more Legion, it was time to take down those Chaos Rude Abyss bosses. We managed to take down 3 doors, needing a bit more work to get ready for Chaos Vellum. We still had temporary burning gear, so being able to replace that was actually pretty nice. This was also the time where the summer event was still active. The Neo Castle event store back then had so many nice items. I got 3 event rings, an android heart and an android from this event, draining all my mesos and event currency, but it was well worth it. I cubed my event rings to 6% stats and epic rarity and kept upgrading my gear along the way. Our stats went up to 12k and I hit 100% crit rate, which was quite important for my Shade because he has pretty low base crit rate. To test our limits, I also did a dojo run and reached stage 37, which wasn't too bad considering this was way before the final damage changes. My next goal was to improve my ignore enemy defense to make bossing possible, and the easiest way to do that was to keep working on my Legion board, like expanding that board and getting more Link skills. So I trained all Explorer mages to at least level 140 for the Link skill, and of course I trained all Explorer thieves for the Link skill as well to increase my damage. Because of all this leveling, our Legion was getting close to 5k again at this point, and of course I kept training my main, reached level 230, unlocking Morass, and the monsters there dropped familiar cards, so I was finally getting started to get some decent familiars as well. And I started doing my weeklies in the scrapyard and demon camp, of course. I did so many weeklies. I finally also took the time to complete the Afterlands questline for some permanent totems, and I completed Black Haven so we could start the Lotus boss fight later, and Monad for the special title. There also was a 5, 10, 15 Starforce event active around that time that we participated in. Man, I would much rather cube than Starforce, but Starforce gains past 15 stars are just too amazing. I blew up a lot of my Fafnir gear, but those were easily to replace at that point, so I didn't really even bother transfer hammering anything. We got 70 stars on our hat, top and bottom with this event. I also cubed my gear a little bit and got some of my new event rings to unique and kept working on the potential of the Fafnir set as well, pushing ourselves to almost 16k main stat. This helped us enormously to take down Harp Magnus and Chaos Vellum. Those fights still took a while, but it was doable with both me and Femke her Paladin duoing them. And I've got my boost notes to level 20 with my most important grinding and bossing skills, so I could hit one more additional monster and just do a lot more final damage. And of course I kept working on my Legion and Link skills. Around November, I had all blocks and Legion Link skills that give IED, except for my Lumens Link skill that's still level 2 at this point. I worked hard on training more and more classes, and in a month I boosted my Legion from 5k to 7k. I trained in Ice Lightning Mage, Hayato, Jet, Wild Hunter, Wind Archer, Kaiser, Dawn Warrior and Tadale all to level 200. I had around 25 characters at level 200 or higher at this point in Reboot. And I started farming familiars to get some IED and Meso familiars. I got two that both give IED, giving us just a little buff to that stat, and because of that we hit 94% IED. I also trained and reached level 235, doing my dailies, and I kept upgrading my symbols. And of course Femke was keeping pace as well. I kept cubing and flaming my gear. We were getting ready to take on Lotus and needed all the stats we could get. I got most of my gear to either unique or legendary and got some really sick stats on my emblem, so I'm keeping that like forever. I reached 90k stats and Femke had 15k stats at this point, and with that we were finally able to take down Lotus. I didn't have enough cores yet, so I had to wait another week after our first kill before I could actually get my first piece of Absalom gear. That was pretty sad. Getting to the point from defeating the Kills with Abyss bosses to being able to defeat Lotus took like a whole month. Progress was quite slow in between. And with that, it was the end of November, the Reboot passive update happened and things were starting to look a lot better. We took down Damien pretty easily thanks to the changes, so we could get even more Absalom gear. And I got lucky, after months of Reboot taking down this boss, Helix finally dropped a belt, so I had one part of the Golic set down now. I got 20k stats, at this point I started finally getting the Absalom pieces. I got a shoulder, gloves, shoes and cape. Next goal was to get a real Absalom weapon to complete the set. I was still using the fake one from Burning. And that takes us to today. And of course, over the last 3 weeks, a lot of stuff has happened. I reached level 240 and finally got enough coins to get the Absalom weapon. We now have the full set complete and I could finally get rid of the fake one. We also cubed it and it was illegal how fast we rolled 3 lines of attacks. I spent perhaps a billion max on getting this weapon to legendary and to roll 3 lines of attack. That's how fast it went. I also finally got most of my rings to legendary and turned them into drop gear. Same with some of my face accessories. I now have 60% meso drop rate and 20% item drop rate. Because of the drop gear, I did lower in stats a little bit though. I now have 21k main stat. So my next goals are getting other rings and accessories to replace my drop gear. That way I'll have one gear set for grinding and one for bossing. I was also finally able to buy a Golex ring the other day. And I kid you not, literally this morning I found the Dominator pendant. After 150 days, I finally got one of those. I also got a Connor ring from Princess No. We'll be cubing all of those next week during Double Miracle Time. So this is where I am right now after 150 days in Reboot, close to 8k Legion. I got my boost notes from Bomb Punch and Spirit Claw, which are my main mobbing and bossing skills, to level 40, and this is my gear. We're using the Afterlands Totem, the rings I showed a bit earlier, two of them have Meso and Drop gear, while the other two are still set to Strength, and I'm still wearing the Kale's Horntail necklace until I start upgrading my Dominator pendant, which I'll do during Double Miracle Time. I'm still super happy with my Absalom weapons potential, and after I rank up those new rings that I'm getting, and I'll still have cubes left, I'll try to roll for better stats on my hat and bottom as well, and hopefully get my shoes to legendary. I was also rolling my potential earlier for some critical damage and strength lines, but no luck on the strength lines so far. We only got critical damage and dex or something like that. I don't think I'm touching my secondary or emblem ever again. Those are pretty fine for now. I also got my ambition to max level for more IED, and now I'm just gonna start doing my dailies and get those symbols hopefully to max level at one point and start working towards 25k stats, and of course get most of my newer gear to 17 stars during the next 5, 10, 15 event, whenever that may be. All those stats helped me out a lot. I'm now able to solo Lotus, which is something that I was never able to do in the regular server, so I'm super happy with that. And in the dojo, I now managed to reach floor 46. Hopefully, we'll soon be able to get to floor 50 with the new gear. And that's 150 days of Reboot progression in 10 minutes. As always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Niels de Konnik, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Riley As, Terry Kim, Varese, Cloudy Mora, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace, OTI, Saffronix, Lonzo, BG Extremes, Anwar NHI, Frank Bouguet, Ziggy Deer, Flidiot, Beamer WT, Knifezoo, Chen125, Cloudfix, Gusus Rodriguez, Froggy11, SirTito655, Glason, Brendan Cam, Vira, Trevor, Michael Machaca, Ratius, Lucky Beats, Justin Vale, Silvio Nato, Stevie Zeng, Afterlord_MS, Heopan, Simak, Joshua Alvarez, Striker Elk, NockMSS, Niu, Taiduan Pan, Victor Sundstrom, Radicals the Alien, Stanislaus Kosumo Begus, Riser RU, Eddie Reacts to Things, Dular, Gummy Bullet, Leon Reddle, Booty Warrior GT, Jeremy Stodler, Mr. Narc, Lovebird, Rev Soli, Yeruski TV, and Yo Mama. Thank you all so much for watching. Stay safe and happy mapling!